My name is Frederik Schreiber and I'm the game director on Rise of a Triad. Today I'm gonna do a Q&A session with you, our fans, so let's get started. Hi guys, so I'm gonna answer a few questions from you guys about Rise of the Triad. The first question here comes from Faisin, and Faisin asks, what is the game about? So Rise of the Triad is about a team called the Hunt Team. And the Hunt Team is basically a Special Forces Task Force team that gets put into an island called San Nicolas Island, close to the shore of Los Angeles. This island has been taken over by something called the Triad, which is a cult that's planning terrorist attacks on Los Angeles. Basically, your mission is to take down the Triad cult and save the city. The thing here is, when you arrive to this island, your boat gets blown up. So you're basically stranded here. So you have to infiltrate the island and kill everyone. So that's the basic story. We haven't dug into the story as much as we wanted to. Basically, Rise of the Triad is not a game that's created for the story itself. So the story is basically just a frame to give any kind of reason for all of the ridiculous things that's going on in the game.
What the hell is?
The next question comes from Tar Hiel, and Tar Hiel asks, how did you approach the dilemma of what to keep from the original game, catering to the nostalgia of fans, and what to add to the game as new things? Basically, we decided to base the game around the framework of the original. So we tried to find what we would call the soul of Rise of the Triad. So we wanted to keep the ridiculous weapons, the crazy enemies, the bosses, the basic layout of the level design, which is based on an exploratory approach, which basically means that we have tons of secrets, multi-pathed approach to the levels, and so on. So we tried to keep that in Rise of the Triad as the core of the game. And then adding what we thought would appeal to new gamers as well, and the hardcore gamers that loves Twitch-based shooters. So we basically built an entirely new game around that foundation of the original game. So what you're getting is a brand new title, a brand new Rise of the Triad. You can consider it a sequel that has the soul and foundation of the original game. Next question here comes from Los Hunto, and Los Hunto asks if all of the versions of the game, GOG, Steam, etc., will use the same multiplayer servers, or if the community will be split. So for Rise of the Triad, we decided to basically create one DRM-free version that gets released on all of the stores to ensure that everyone can play against everyone. Instead of using Steamworks and other third-party backend that is exclusive to their store, we decided to design our own backend, which basically is comparable to something like Battle.net, for instance, from Blizzard. That means that no matter where you buy the game, you will be able to log in and play online against your friends, with your friends, check the leaderboards, check your scores and stats and so on. So everything is unified. So if you have a friend who bought the game on GOG, and you bought it on Steam, you'll be able to play against each other, chat together, and so on. So that was a very important factor for us, to make sure that you weren't punished for buying the game on a store that was DRM-free. We wanted everyone to have the same great experience from Rise of the Triad. Next question here comes from Keskirs Kinra. How enriching will the story be? What emotional depths can we feel for these characters? I would say the most emotional depth you will feel from the characters are the one-liners they say when eyeballs splatter on the screen. That's pretty much the closest we'll get to anything emotional in the game. As far as that, we're having a ton of fun with it. You know, when creating these characters, we tried to create a personality for each one of them, and gave each of them a distinct, very, very stereotypical personality that fits within the ridiculous universe of Rise of the Triad. So I think you'll like it.
Woof, woof, motherfucker.
The next question comes from Jay Heminger. And Jay Heminger basically asks if there was anything that was too ridiculous to put in the game. When creating a game like this, you come up with a lot of crazy ideas, and the original Rise of the Triad was basically made from crazy ideas that you would normally not put in a video game. But you basically decided to put everything into Rise of the Triad, creating this insanely fun and ludicrous game. We took the exact same approach. There's a difference between bad ideas and then crazy ideas. And every crazy idea we had that would supplement the basic foundation and core of Rise of the Triad, we put in the game. So there's nothing that's too crazy to put in there. I would say one of the ideas that was really, really fun to work with was how do we create a new drunk missile that's interesting. The old drunk missile was fun, but it was kind of similar to all the other weapons, you know, basic one-shot rockets, except that it shot five rockets instead of one rocket. We decided to say, okay, let's make a rocket-launching Gatling gun. And that was pretty much the brainstorming session. Let's make a rocket-launching Gatling gun. And we just did it, and it turned out insanely awesome. So yeah, a lot of crazy ideas that fit within a game like this, and that just makes it so much more fun to work with. The last question here comes from Roman5, and he asks, what was the most interesting enemy type or boss that you liked the most? And which one of the enemy types did you have most fun working with? I would say personally, my favorite is probably the NME. Just because the original enemy model required us to take some new liberties into creating a new model. There were some rights in according to Doctor Who and so on, which the original bosses were based off. We basically decided to just go overboard with the NME, and we created this giant stomping metal spider boss that just walks around and shoots rockets like everywhere. Completely insane boss, and it was so much fun to work with because it looks kind of cute even though it's just a giant. You know, it runs around and looks like it stumbles over its own legs, and it was just insanely fun to work with, and it looks absolutely badass. So I'd say my favorite boss is the enemy in the game. So that was basically it. Thank you guys for pre-ordering the game, and thank you for letting me participate in this small Q&A session. I hope you'll like the game, and I'm looking forward to playing with you on July 31st.
You want to have some more wine?
Oh yes, thank you, Mom.